still grooving, delivering a dope flow that's way beyond ordinary. Contrary to his moniker, Dyme-A-Duzin reps BK to the fullest. So if you're wondering, where Brooklyn at? It's right here and right now on this extra lit episode of B-Side. You ready to get your grooving gear? I'm your host, Grant Yanney, and I'm gonna need you to keep it locked to the B-Side. Let's get it going.
Never been a slave to the fame, son. Still a giving them see the beats that they play some. Still a manager, managers to say stay away from. Still planning this world domination. Imagine a shape shifting our ways through your radio stations. Getting paid in places you never could play in. Calling me competition and you caught in the matrix. I'm Dyme, I'm Keanu, y'all agents. You must have popped the Molly and forgot who you came with. Some Trinidad James. Your Puma discs ain't got the same fit. Your compacts ain't got the same hits. You ready for combat and I'm sitting on the Empire way. Yeah. Hey. Feeling so unreal. Hey. Feeling so unreal. Brooklyn. I'm feeling so unreal. Damn. Rappers biting styles, never paying homage, tapes of garbage. I'm spitting rounds now, so name the target. Spitting the cart, you can take me watching. Blogging and begging whoever's artist, look, I'm taking part in naming offering. I'll double that and then I'll take them all, you think you hard, but I think it's management, just raping artists, taking profit. But you so loyal, you and patriotic, that you bend over and take it all. A shameful dog, I'm praising ganja. I'm fried, no tan, over your rhymes are transparent, my flows are transforming these men. I'm menstruating, relaxed. No tans for them, mad they moving packs. And I'm traveling the lands for and I was die for this. 11 years I had to strive to get the title shit. So why these sisters got such a sense of entitlement? Fake followers and viral hits. It's rough for rappers, all I shine don't make you diamond, kid. Hey, feeling so unreal. I'm feeling so unreal. Feeling so unreal. The real swag. I'm out for presidents to represent me. I'm out for I'm out for presidents to represent me. 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 Dyme. Yeah. They waiting on me. They waiting on me. Waiting for the Viago. These rappers corny. Like how dare you start? But your big homies big homie. Like flows don't roll deep. My only brody ho, I'm broke deep. Only know me. The whole team is for themselves. Solely and ducats more when you know them. They were fucking and let your soul leave. I'm charging bricks for mixing. They playing in the net killers. I'm on the internet killing. I ain't into the twitting. So I'm off and they be killing attendance. Put your career in the coffin. Forgetting caught in your feelings. Or pretending your children. This isn't war, it's a scrimmage. Got a problem, then I'm coming at your boss with the business. Show me your leader. Show me a hook. Play me a heater. Show me a song. Show me a vid. I never seen one. Spit something hard. Scribble the bar. Respond back. Like your chick hasn't been in every kid in my squad's life. But I don't judge a past. We used to date. When I saw her last, she was drunk on 40s telling us how you be. Fast, the last violated, Chris Lighty co-signed. You just a groupie, Ryan getting no shine. Rating rappers Running in the ring, giving stunners and clotheslines. Reading on my sweat for too long, and now I want mine. The pioneer, annihilation, the dollar thing, and the dollar's in. Feeling so unreal. Goddamn. Feeling so unreal, so unreal, so unreal, so unreal. Machine. TV, B-side. Feels so good to be in Brooklyn tonight, man. It feels so good to be from Brooklyn tonight, man. All the time. Right? Shit!
Give it up. Give it up. I feel like I'm in like a hip-hop symphony orchestra in this piece, man. This is awesome. Man. Yo, can you just introduce yourselves and, you know, the band and Dyme-A-Duzin, you know, just go ahead and we can start with you and go through the rest of the band.
Well, I got the mic on me, right? My name is Dyme-A-Duzin. Donovan Malik Block is the real name. I'm from Crown Heights, Brooklyn. It's my man Majid. You know, talk, man.
My name is Majid, violinist, composer, love to be here. I'm glad I'm here with the team to play some music. We have Alex. Come on.
I'm the bass player.
Alex. Alex Busby Smith on the bass. We have Norman Paul Edwards Jr.
What's
on the drums.
Norman Paul Edwards Jr.
Yes.
Okay.
And we have
awesome.
Willem Dellis Fort, the one and only.
Awesome, awesome. So, I want to start things off. So, you know, you grew up. I was told you weren't able to listen to hip hop, and you know, that there was a perceived negativity there, but you wrote your first song at the age of 11. Can you tell us about that, and what motivated you to write that song?
Well, yeah, in my house, I wasn't really allowed at all to listen to rap, because my mom, she's in the audience somewhere, she, you know, we went really into church, and she just wanted to keep us away from like worldly things. And, you know, I had little sisters too, so women negation, you know, like all that stuff. So I wasn't really exposed to it, but you know, through church, I was introduced to rapping by a gospel rapper. So one of my first songs was actually a gospel rap called Keeping It Godly, and it was a remix on Fabulous's Keeping It Gangsta.
Mm-hmm. Check that out. Yeah, and I mean, how do you feel about that? Because I mean, right now in music, gospel rap and just artists, you know, expressing themselves, you know, expressing, you know, their belief system and spirituality, that's very heavy in music right now. So, I mean, what's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I definitely feel like I'm a vessel. You know, I am, you know, here to, you know, preach, not preach the gospel, but show what, you know, what God could do, you know. Like, you know, I feel like God's got me through a lot, and through example, you know, I can help other people with it, or however he wants me to, you know, go about this musical thing and this talent he's given me. So, you know, I do it for him, you know?
Mm-hmm. Awesome. How would you describe yourself?
Sheesh. Swanky.
Hey. Swanky. And you know, I noticed that. I feel like your last project, A Portion of Donovan, you gave your fans a lot more swankier, clean-cut presentation. You seem to have come back, you know, with a lot more grittier, you know what I'm saying, feel. And it's reflective in, you know, the sound, and it's also reflective just with your personal style now. Like, can you explain that?
I mean, you know, we grow, we go through different stages in our lives, different eras. Like, You know, we just all building, and you know, I'm just continuing to grow. I'm just, you know, I'm not really just planning what I'm gonna do next. I'm just doing what I feel. Mm-hmm. And it's all Brooklyn, so it's like, hey, all my influence is just Brooklyn, so it's just, mm-hmm, it's always gonna be from the root.
And so, and since we're speaking about Brooklyn, what is it about Brooklyn that you feel makes so many just authentic, you know, intrinsically just real artists? Like, what is it about Brooklyn? There's so many just dope MCs that come from this borough, that come from New York City as a whole. What is it about Brooklyn?
I mean, the Brooklyn demeanor, I mean, I don't know if, you know, everybody would agree with me, but I feel like in Brooklyn, like, we feel like we are the best borough. So I wouldn't be, I'm not surprised that, you know, the best rappers come out of this borough. So, hey, you know, we got the J's, we got the Biggies, you know, and we have to live up to that. You know, me as an MC or a performer, whatever, you know, I look at these guys from the Busta Rhymes, the Biggies, the Jay-Z's, and I'm like, damn, how can I come through in my era and be a gift to the game as they were in my own way? Mm-hmm. And it's pressure, you know? But, you know, those guys are great, and I just, you know, I just want to be as great as them.
Mm-hmm. Which songs are you most connected to? Involving first, you know, your borough, Brooklyn, from your favorite artists, and which one of your own songs are you connected to?
Well, speaking, keeping on the Brooklyn topic, as far as like Jay-Z and Big, Brooklyn's Finest is a record that I grew up with that I still, to this day, still bump, still so classic. Jay-Z and Biggie back and forth, the best in Brooklyn, going bar for bar, amazing. Y'all know about Brooklyn's Finest, right? One of my favorite songs right now, which is pretty ironic, because I was just played on the radio on doing a Brooklyn mix. They played Biggie and Jay, then they played a song with me and Fab. Mm-hmm. So me and Fabulous just did a song called That Chicken. So right now, thank you. Mm-hmm. That's a big thing for me, being co-signed by a Brooklyn veteran, and you know, that's much respect for him to, you know, just really just give me that nod and say, yo, you doing your thing. And you know, that's, I'm connected to that song right now.
That's a groove. We're gonna get back into that actually after the next one, man.
For so, sure.
Peace. Let's get back.
Sheesh.
Body on Me.
All right, so this next song is called Body on Me, right?
That's right.
This is off the Hip Hop Project, right?
That's right.
Wow. Last joint was called Real Swing. It's Body on Me. Something a little bit smoother, something like. Shorty on me, she gonna need be. Get a hold of your freak and she'll probably OD. Cause when she hit my phone, I know it's cause she probably one day put that body on me. Wanna put that body on me. She wanna put that body on me. Hey, yo, nigga, I'm so out of your reach. You know it, then you probably want beef. Got you grinding your teeth, got the finest little freaks. Cause everywhere we go, they know that we the flyest low key. Got that fire on me. Yo, sin is kinda quiet, loud like a siren. Sheriff got his eye on police. Pigs be patrolling, blowing while I'm strolling. Homie, I'm a phony OG. Bringing you that real, something you can feel. That's how you show they probably know me. If she can't spit a rap verse, then she probably gon' sing. She a microphone fan. I swear that she can rock it so good that I probably won't beat you massaging her feet. You kiss you when you shake it. Cause you, hey, you gonna, she be calling on me. Now get a hold of your freak. Cause when she hit my phone, she probably won't deep. Put that body on me, so right. Hey, that body on me, so. Shout out to Ari Lennox. Woo! Verse 2, it's like, they say rap is always rapping about taking your women. Well, that's probably cause we taking your women. By mistake, but I did it. Think they yours and that they faithful. You mistaken for women. Then they all up in our faces every place that we visit. From the D to the go, Houston back to New York, Carolina, Toronto, California, Atlanta. You were keen to buy the ring. You should be grateful you didn't. All my G's agree with me cause they relate to the feeling and they know.
hit it in the number ain't a day, yo. Just a swanky nigga, hey, what can I say though? Smoke the blunt and bust it, now we both a KO. If we get busted, it's okay though, because it's shorty probably won't. Ho! And she'll probably OD, cause when she hit my phone, she probably won't put that body on me. Wanna put that body on me. She wanna put that body on me. She wanna put that. She wanna put that. Break it down like. You know, we from Brooklyn. We love Brooklyn. But I got love for everybody. Shout out the West Coast. Rest in peace, Nate Dogg. When I met you last night, baby, before you opened up your, I had respect for your lady, but now I take it all back, hey, because you gave me all your old. Your number on the cabinet, and I promise, babe, I'll give you a call. Woo! Next time you're feeling kinda, just come on over and I can break you off. And if you can't, that day, baby, just lay back and open your. And open, it ain't no fun. 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 It ain't no fun.
Shout out Nate Dogg. Shout out Dyme-A-Duzin. Yes, 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 man. So, we already spoke about Brooklyn. I know you went to Murrow High School, you know, you had a lot of different, seemed like that was just like a creative boom at that school. It was a lot of musicians and artists. Can you care speak about that? You know, you've been in the industry, you know, since you've been a young guy, so.
Well, yeah, I went to Murrow High School with like Joey Badass and Capital Steez and all the Pearl Era guys. And yeah, Murrow had a lot of ill Brooklyn cats come out of there. I think Busta went there. Jerry Seinfeld went to Murrow, I believe, too. A bunch of people came out of that school, so, you know, it's a very historical, you know, school and a moment for us in that generation, because, you know, Capital Steez passed away, rest in peace. You know, I was lucky enough to be, like, you know, one of his right-hand men. Like, we would run around together, just write rhymes together, and I got a lot of good memories of him, so, you know, I take a lot of pride in Murrow.
Mm-hmm. And I also know, you know, you used to be in the band Phony People.
Yes, sir.
Explain what that time period was like with that sound. And I know it was like a movement of sorts, you know? Like, how did you guys get together, the Phony People guys?
Oh, that's another thing. We met in, well, I met LB3 in Murrow, which is actually, you know, one of the co-founders. And, you know, we got started from there. And, you know, I would go over to his house along with other band members and friends that we made. And, you know, we developed that band. We ended up touring with Erykah Badu, The Roots, Mos Def, Talib Kweli. So that whole, you know, performance experience has definitely, you know, built up my performance. And it's been a, you know, definitely it adds to my performance quality because, you know, I can perform with a band. I can do the DJ thing. It's just a blessing, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and before we went to break the last time, we spoke about That Chicken. And before I talk about the Fabulous record, I want to speak about the original record. Mm. So, That Chicken, you explore some deep topics there. You touch on depression, a sense of desperation due to economic conditions, amongst other things. You care to touch on that?
Oh, well, that chicken, it just comes from, you know, an observation of the things, you know, around us and what's going on in the hood in Brooklyn, Crown Heights, particularly, you know, and all around the world, really. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just a, you know, we all need money, you know, and it's, some of us are in, you know, unfortunate situations where we can't get it as like we want to, and we go, you know, desperate measures, you feel mm-hmm. me? And it's a true thing, and, you know, there are layers on top of, you know, I feel like there's such a need to be tough in hip-hop, you know, like, even in the black community, like, thoughts of suicide, that those are like, yo, we don't do that, don't, you know, what are you doing? You know, but it happens, you know, and, you know, depression happens, but we don't get a chance to talk about it and speak up about it because we don't feel that our peers or our elders are even welcoming to, like, that type of talk. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I feel like I was just going deeper into the layers with that, you know, that song, that chicken. Mm-hmm.
But you seem really grounded, you know, for a young guy. Like, what keeps you, your foundation, like, what keeps you aloft?
I mean, I just got a lot of great people around me, you know, my mother especially, just, you know, raising me and, you know, showing me the right way. And you know, just the people I keep around me, you know, the people that aren't the best, they always end up, you know, just fading away, and the real people always stay. So I want everybody out there to remember that, like, everybody that's in your life is in there for a reason, and if you're trying to force them to be, then, they shouldn't.
Well, you got Fabulous just came into your life, man. Like,
and that's a blessing
that
too. He's a great guy. Like, one of the most down to earth artists I've met. You know, it's dudes that are not even like his caliber yet, and they act Hollywood to me like they're Jay-Z. But so it's like for him, like Fabulous, a dude I've been listening to all my life. You know, just like I said, keeping it godly. Like, that really just occurred to me. Like, dang, I really remixed this song when I was like 11 years old, and now he's like. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're gonna get to that record a little bit later, but you know, we're getting ready to get into this next song, guys. It's Triple Darkness.
Hey. This is just listen to this. I'm rapping on this. I like to rap. You guys ready? Hope for hip hop.
Headphones on the H-train, my bass blaring. Cause I ain't caring, they keep staring at me like I don't have a second to breathe. Paycheck spent cause I invested in trees just to connect with my celestial beings. They told me never stress because I'm destined to lead. You win it for the bitches, then it's best to leave. Cause resting with these heavens, how you catch a disease? Follow me now. Fresh is in the school, never tested. Press the mess with because he cool, but his sex spit. Never take his kindness for weakness. To the side of your tie, that your t-shirt, that find you in bleachers. He body who beeping. Solemnly the side of them seeing. Killing calves in the calf, cause nobody can beat him. A cash cow now. Gotta be somebody to see him. Me overseas, he ain't seen. He ain't even seen. Put the strings for young king. Flawless, lawless. Regardless, triple darkness, flawless, lawless, regardless, triple darkness, flawless, lawless, regardless, triple darkness, triple darkness. Hold up. Just when you thought New York rap was gone, I gift wrapped the bomb. Bump it hard through your city black, something hard for the city caps. See a pimp stacking like a dealer, L's lit, I'm hot. I'm here to provide, but still Biggie Pop. You should already know my steed. These Molly rappers are tough. Tell them easy on the E, yeah. No pun intended. Flawless, lawless, regardless, triple darkness. Flawless, lawless, regardless, triple darkness. Flawless, lawless. Regardless, triple darkness. Hope for hip hop. Hope for hip hop.
Jeez, I love that, the violin, man.
Thank
wow.
You.
Triple Darkness. That was on Hip Hope.
Yes, sir.
The beat was by
Élan.
How did that collaboration come about? I hear a lot of great things about Élan. I just, you know.
Élan is my favorite producer. He's a really good producer. Grammy nominated, platinum, Kanye West, 50 Cent, all them guys. Honored to work with him. Yeah, I want to do some more work with him, man. He got some beats. But yeah, Triple Darkness, that's just a record we came up with. He gave me the beat, sat down, came up with that. It's about, you know, just, yeah, it's a deeper meaning I can't really get into right now.
Okay. Well, speak about the meaning of hip hop. That was the title of the project. You know, you had a lot of nice guest features and just good sounds. You had Kehlani on there. You know, that's pre-Grammy nomination. You got a lot of, you know, nice, you know, medleys on that album, that project. So
thank you.
What's the message in hip hop? Like, I hear there's like a strong title there.
You know, just keeping, you know, hip hop alive through musicality, through togetherness, through experimentation, just not doing the same thing, just getting back to the roots, but at the same time, you know, embracing the new. You know, hip hop just taking the culture seriously. I feel like we don't really, in today's culture, a lot of people really don't take the art seriously, and they, you know, get on and in different ways that are not really hip hop or doing, like, they're not sticking to the code. So, you know, you just got, we have hope for hip hop, you know?
Mm-hmm. And, you know, you talk about those guys getting on, like, how do you feel about the music being created right now? You know, some people would say, oh, it's like more of a turn up ratchet era, or it's, you know, it's hip hop is dead. Like, I mean, where do you view music at? I mean, are you happy where it's at right now? Do you feel like, you know? It's
like I said, you know, I feel like we should always embrace the new, but you just gotta have respect for the art form. Like, you know, it came from somewhere, it means something, you know? Mm-hmm. You can't just, you know, just be making, like, you just gotta respect it, you know? Mm-hmm. Hip-hop, and coming from New York, you know, I gotta enforce it. I feel responsible. Like.
Mm-hmm. And with that responsibility, because you've been, you know, a major signed artist, you've also been indie. In your truthful, honest opinion, do you feel there's pros and cons? Like, do you feel like it's a greater burden to be a signed artist versus an indie artist, or vice versa?
I have this line. I said, nowadays, the industry ain't what it seems. It ain't about the record label, it's about your team. You know, it's about your team, you know. A team can work just like the record label, you know. You know, it's people that come from record labels that know the whole format that can just join a team of indie people and be like, okay, this is what we need, this is what we can do, and then this is just how the record label works. Let's work this with our friends, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just, you know, it's about your team, I feel like, you know. Whether a record label or not, it's about the team.
Okay. Speak on My Single. I know that's another record you're going to do.
My Single. It was called Layers at first because I had so many ideas and melodies on this particular smooth track. And I just, you know, made it my single. You know, it's about being in a relationship and dealing with somebody that's also in a relationship. But when y'all together, you know, it's a different story. You kind of put it to the side. And not necessarily the best thing to do. Cheating, but you know, it's real. Things happen.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. And yeah, My Single. We're gonna get into that one next.
Sheesh.
These findings got you stressed. Now I finally put your body to the test. What it is, what it do. What you hiding in that dress? Am I finding gold a diamond in your chest? Is it there? Who are you? She don't know My Single, but she like me. She ain't even single, but she like me. She don't know My Single, but she like me. Let them talk about it, so what? Fuck them, they don't even know us. Call me when you're coming over. Got so much I wanna show ya. I'm longing for your lust again. Your bitches got me practicing. No, I ain't come to kick it with you. you. Cause clearly we too old to be frightened. Take your clothes off or something. It's the two of us and knowing this round. I want us to explore one another, never blow it up. Cause you're the name my style. Now let me lay you down. Know these spinals got you stressed. Now I finally put the body to the test. What it is, what it do. What you hiding in that dress? Am I finding gold or diamond in your chest? Is it there? Who are you? She don't know my single, but she like me. She ain't even single, but she like me. Hey, she don't know my single, but she like me. We ain't even take off your shoes. Let me get your coat. Let me spark this conversation while we sip this slow. Stimulate your mind until I strip your soul. Get a snippet of what's inside before I enter hoes. Hold up, my homies wanna work of art. I hope to bring her home to MoMA. She was holy till she ran that holy road. Now she be way. Cause clearly we too old to be frontin'. Taking clothes off or something. Miss the two of us and knowing this around. I want us to explore one another. Girl, that ain't my style. Hey! You know that I've been wanting you. Showed you my soul, now show these. I know this moment's overdue, but I had to find the time to find myself in you, hey. I know you do. I know you do. Hey. Yeah. She like a model. She like a model. Hey. She like a model from a video. So fine, I even got her in my video. Hey. Gotta see me every time you in my city. Gotta see me every time you in my city. Like a model from a video. So fine, I even got her in my video. Gotta see me every time you in my city. Yeah. Gotta see me every time you in my city, yeah. She don't know my single. Yeah. She don't know my. Woo!
I want to bring you in to this one as well. How did you guys end up linking with Donovan?
It's a very interesting story. Very interesting story. A DJ friend of mine by the name of DJ Caliban. DJ Caliban. Mm-hmm. He said, man, you know, I'm going to be DJing down by 5 points. I'm going to be down by 5 points.
Very
so
hip-hop.
He said, come through and I'm going to introduce you to some people, let them know what you're doing, and we just hang out and do whatever. Molly was there. He's a Molly Mall's protege. And so, you know, he came down. I came down, hanging out with him, chilling, meeting everybody. And I'm in the crowd. Craig G is there. I'm kicking it with Craig G, the OG from Queensbridge, which is the Queensbridge area. He just came through. And we're in there, and then spot this guy. And he goes, we just started talking. Mm-hmm. You remember, we were just talking. And his friend goes, hey man, I'm a rapper. His friend says it. Mm-hmm. His friend says, I'm a rapper. So I'm like, cool, you know, I have a band, I do these things and this. He's kind of a shy guy. He's not very forward. So he was just relaxing. He was just relaxing the whole time. Near the end of the thing, his man just kind of walks away and he's like, yeah, you know, I rap a little too. I'm like, okay. So I have this band. He goes, yeah, I've been in a band before. I like the band sound. I was like, okay, cool. He goes, I'm going to be going to Amsterdam and I'm looking for a band. Are you able to do it? And I'm like, man, I'm about to go to Japan, fly out to Japan. So I was like scratching my chin. I was like, you know what? I'm going to get back to you on that. And the next day, called them, linked up. The rest is history. It's funny how that worked out, but it was beautiful. It was real.
It's meant to be, man.
Meant to be, indeed. Wow. I remember it like it was yesterday.
And speaking on Amsterdam, I know you also, you had that overseas run. You had a nice tour. You were in London and, you know, different places over there. Speak on your experience. Is this your first time down there? And like, what did you see and how did that like really ultimately impact your sound, music?
Oh man, I was in London, Switzerland, Stuttgart, Germany, which was very random, but it was nice. Munich, Bristol, you know, just all these places, just like new experiences. And I was actually like riding the train out there on some like, you know, like citizens, just like living their life. Like, you know, and it was really cool. A lot of people out there knew the words and the lyrics. It just shows you how like the internet can really just stretch, you know, the music across the seas. And it was very inspiring and, you know, another, something else that added to, you know, me as a person, you know, so new experiences. Going away always changes your perspective, especially out overseas and traveling out there, like, you know, sick.
Mm-hmm. What inspired the name? Like, it's when I hear the name Dyme-A-Duzin, like, where did that come from?
Well, I once heard someone say rappers come a Dyme-A-Duzin, and I kind of wanted to take that name and make it like as ironic as possible, kind of take it and like be like the most standout or the, you know, strive to be the most, you know, the best rapper I could be to make that name ironic, like, you know, more like a diamond in the rough, like, you know, and then I look at it like, you know, a dozen styles, perfect 10, like, I gotta have, like, a variety of styles, and I just gotta strive to be the best I am at them, you know, dime a dozen, dozens of dimes, you know, and, you know, again, there's other ways it could go, too, but, you know, mm-hmm. a lot of different meanings, but, you know, that was, like, my first one as a kid. I came up with that name, Q the Prophet, actually, one of my mentors from church, the guy I heard rap for the first time, he actually helped me out with that name. So, you know, that was like 11 years old. You know? Mm-hmm. Had it for a long time.
So how much would you say that you've changed as an artist? I mean, you've been rapping since you're 11. You're experiencing life, you know, you're traversing through this life and, you know, going to another country, in different countries, you get to experience different culture. How important do you feel that has made you artistically?
You know, it's inspiring just to go overseas and like hear the different music and then see how people respond to the music out there too. So it kind of like puts like, it makes me tweak my sound so I can kind of like appeal more to what they hear and what they like. You know, it's just like all learning experience and, you know, that was a big one, going overseas and just being out there and learning and performing. Trying to do it again real soon. Anybody from overseas in the crowd right now? Ooh. Oh, hey. She said. I'm coming to where you live. I'm coming.
You know, what about like politics? I know sometimes, you know, it's a lot of stuff happening right now. I'm just always curious about, you know, what, you know, our generation, the youth, you know, like, what are we thinking, especially as it relates to artists? Like, well, you going like Bernie, Hillary, or Yeezy?
I was a real, you know, a Bernie supporter because, first of all, he was from Brooklyn. I don't know. I don't want to just say it because he's from Brooklyn, but he just really, you know, he was connecting. I listened to a lot of his, you know, speeches, a lot of his interviews and his viewpoints. But the way things are going in America just right now is just really just weird. And it's like show business. Politics is like show business. It's like, that's what I'm thinking about it right now. Like, can you be, like, you can seriously, like Trump and then want him to win? Like, that's like, it seems like it's a movie happening or something like that. Mm-hmm. You know? Yeah. I'm not really into that.
Speaking about movies, how much of your art do you feel, is it art imitating life or life imitating art?
Ooh. It's, you know, a little bit of both. You said life imitating art or art imitating life. I mean, you know, mostly art and imitating life, or like a little bit of both, man. That was a good question, bro.
Thank you. You know, we're gonna cook a little bit, and you cooking with this new album, Crown Fried, man. Like, speak about Crown Fried. That's the new project you're getting ready. You know.
So Crown Fried, you know, we from Brooklyn, so Crown Fried's everywhere. So you know, I kind of took that concept. And I kind of made it, like, I looked at it like, I compared the amount of Crown Fried restaurants in our hood to, like, the way we live, like, in the hood. Like, you know, Crown Fried is quick, you know, it's easy, it's that easy chicken, you know? You know, on this side, you know, some of us, like, we need that easy chicken, and we go out and do the, you know, the bad thing. Like, we eat, you know, eat the bad stuff, and we go do the bad thing at the same, like, at the end of the day, it's really just not good for us, you know, and it's killing us at the same time, you know. And a lot of, I look at the word like crown fried, like your crown chakra is fried, like we out here like putting this stuff in our bodies and, you know, it's really just dimming us down. And, you know, you can either like, you know, rise to the occasion, wear your crown or stay fried, you know, so it's like a, you know, interesting dynamic.
Mm-hmm. Right, bars. You know what I'm saying? Speaking of chakra, like alignments and different things spirituality-wise, how have your spiritual studies impacted your art?
I mean, another shout out to Capital Steez, you know, spirit science, and, you know, he put me on an ad, and I started looking through, you know, chakras, and, you know, that started, you know, back in, like, 2012 when he put me on an ad, so from there, I could really, you know, I started putting that stuff in my lyrics. You know, as far as, like, you know, Christianity and stuff, that's always been there, like I said, you know, but, yeah, you know, it's a big part of, you know, who I am. Mm-hmm.
And I know you, I read an interview and you were talking about you used to also help Steez with the bars and like you guys were just
back
inspiring
and forth
one another. Like when you were like first starting to rap, like could you explain your, you know, bar construction? Like how did you begin your writing style and how was you writing your rhymes?
Bruh, my first rap was, oh my God, we come through keeping the godly. That is true. Keeping the godly. From the, I don't know what the hell, from the 345. I don't know what the hell was I saying. I said, from the 345, keeping the godly, Jesus alive, keeping the godly. Like, you know, it was just like, you know, I was going for it back then. Like, some people taught me how to, like, structure bars. Mm-hmm. And, like, that's where it came from. Like, me really getting into, like, writing and, you know, knowing that 16 bars is a verse and a hook is 8 bars, you know. My mentor, Cue the Prophet, once again, he kind of like helped me with that. So I kind of followed that throughout my career. Now I kind of like switch it up. I kind of manipulate it because I know the formula so well. So, you know, the basics until now, you know, getting creative with it.
Okay. Let's get to some more bars. All right.
What are we going for? Chicken.
That chicken. That's previously mentioned.
I got a song called That Chicken. First time performing it live, like with a live band. Yeah, man. Shout out to Majid. Yo, these guys are great right now, man. Give it up for them, man. I'm trying to keep up. Fold it. Let's go. Laying it down for that chicken. Spray a couple rounds for that chicken. They don't play around for that. Go around and you get found for that. On Utica. Them shooters are shooting ya. The move pharmaceuticals come throwing them to ya. No matter what you into, just always stay lifted. All of the time I'm so lifted. My mama crying, I'm too gifted. Why are you not so explicit? You different, but I live it. All of this crime in my vision. Police just raided my sisters. Nephew and niece in the system. Damn. Feeling like I got nobody. Wonder if I got the crew. And they don't really got nobody. So what we really got? If you scared, go to Mastic. Some Mastic is in the back and the passenger. Strap down one jack with the cash from ya. But they shoot with accuracy if you whacking up. Blasphemy, how we praying for a come up. Dimming like shades in the summer. Toting AKs with a drummer. Outraged when police lay our brothers next week on the same street. Spraying with another nigga. Stress is on my mind. Stress my sober mind. Though the hood is weak, we find good at speaking these texts of the times. Trace sketches for the blind. Shit webs that don't define. But these record execs don't check for a nigga. But a check, I'm loading mine. Loading now. Laying it down for that chicken. Spray a couple rounds for that chicken. They don't play around for that. Go around and you get found for that. On Utica. Them shooters are shooting ya. They move pharmaceuticals, come through and they'll shoot at ya. No matter what you into.
drug dealers, most of them gangbang. All of us real, all in the same game. They moving that product, my music that product. Sling dope for that change, man, like who was Obama? On Utica, Utica, your boo is on Utica. She hit my computer up, a few of them fewer bucks. Her tickets came through with her, ran through, now I'm through with her. Tell me how come all the folks be on double, they just getting through with her. Switching lanes, bitch, bitches, frames, bitch. Rocking shit you never seen like it's plain. Been the man to slow down the van, took the dollar van down the plaza, fam. Got him stand like I never seen a Filipino goddess in the projects, damn. I remember bullets popping outside the apartment, I sucking and dodging them. I don't remember last night, I was high off a lot of pins and a lot of zins. Chopping grins on my yachty mints, popping mollies in the promised land. Red assist behind my car, yeah. Serving chickens out the car, yeah. Laying the good down for that shit. Spray a couple rounds for that shit. They don't play around for that. Fuck around and you get found for that. On Utica, 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 Utica. Them shooters are shooting ya. Them shooters are shooting ya. They move pharmaceuticals. Come through and they'll shoot at ya. No matter which one you want to. I don't know why I feel so bright. My tears are dry. Till I lose my heart. Feeling like I got nobody. Wonder if I got the crew. And they don't really got nobody. We don't really got you. Before that. Pull that chick. Pull that chick.
Hey, y'all about to get me started in here, man. Y'all about to get me started out, man. Cut it out. Y'all about to get me started, man. That chicken, the beat. When you first got the beat, what was your thoughts going through your head? What were you trying to do with it, man? Cause,
I mean, I just heard that joint and that was the one. Like the dude, D-Mate, shout out to James Major, sent me a whole lot of other beats. But I picked that one out and I was like, that's the one. It just had like this airy vibe to it and it felt like what I was going through at that time, like living in Crown Heights and being around all this, you know, this energy, this negative and positive, this violence and peace is like so much going on, this change, this, you know, gentrification and all this stuff, like, it was that, it felt like that, you know? Like a sad turn up, like, you know?
Yeah, I hear you. And Utica, Utica, that's like a part that stands out, it resonates with a lot of people, everyone's like, Utica, 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 Utica. Can you explain that for people that might not be from Brooklyn, they don't know about
Well, Utica, if you're from Utica. Brooklyn and you've been on Utica and Eastern Parkway, you got a bunch of dollar cabs that's always right there. And like when you get off the 4 train or the 3 train, you come up and they're always trying to take you to King's Plaza. So like Utica, Utica Plaza, you know?
Just like that.
Just like that. Mm-hmm. Flatbush. Yeah.
And those are the dollar cabs and they're all going
yeah,
down.
Yeah, dollar cabs, they, you know, they
pack it up. It's 24/7, they don't.
I mean, basically, you know, they on the corner picking up the people, taking them where they need to go. It's like the second bus, and it's been like that for years.
Wow. I want to also talk about, you know, some of those bars. We want to get to the bars here with B-Side. You got a line where you said, you know, feeling like you got nobody, wondering if you have a crew. You've been a part of several crews since you started your career. You know, hip-hop, very strong crews, you know. Egos kill many of them, unfortunately. How important is it to have a crew, or is this something that you care about?
I mean, at this point, you know, I feel like me not working out in crews is kind of like, you know, it's just leading me to the direction of me just being like, you know, my own artist. Like, every artist doesn't need a crew. You know, I love, like, I have a crew of people that I roll with, but, you know, it's a difference between a crew and, like, a rap group. And, you know, that gets difficult when you got your friends and you want to make them rappers and, you know, you want to put them in the crew and be like, yo, this is, you know, everybody's not on the same page. So it's like, you know, it's tough. I link up with a group of rappers that I feel like are gonna be on some like, or whoever, creatives, you know, I'm just be on my, you know, I'm Dimes, you know.
Mm-hmm. Are there any creatives at this point where you, you know, have a strong, you know, urge to like wanna link up with and work with, or who's some guys you think?
I mean, I can tell you who I like musically right now.
Or women.
Oh yeah. Dang, a female and guy group like 2088 or something like that.
No, I'm just speaking just individual MCs or singers or bands.
I'm a real big fan of Anderson .Paak. Mm-hmm. I like, you know, Chance the Rapper. Who else is out there?
Majid,
of course, he's the best best rapper. female, I like Rihanna. Mm-hmm. Who else? It's some like really dope up and coming acts. My homegirl LA, she's dope. Yeah, man, I wouldn't say anybody like I would be in a group with. I just really like their music. Mick Jenkins. Yeah. Who am I missing? I feel like if I say like the basic names, I can be like, oh, okay, Drake. Like I like the Drake album. Right. I do. It's cool. What else? Yeah, you know, yay, Vic Mensa, shout out to Vic Mensa. I'm gonna name a lot of Chicago cats, man.
Yeah, that's
shout out to Chicago.
Yeah. Shout out to Chicago. So, you mentioned Chicago. You got guys right here as well. You know, you're Joey Badass. You got, you know, obviously Fabulous. You got the record with him. Like, who's from Brooklyn where you're like, man, I would want to work with them, or you know, I would like to create with.
I mean, there's a lot of people that's in Brooklyn that's up and coming that I've did stuff, things with already, you know. Mm-hmm. Great artists like Joey, I did Achievers, the Flatbush Zombies, Nitty Scott, I got music with her. She might be from Florida, but she lives in New York. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, you know, it's a real, the guys that I've worked with in New York already, I like them. Like, I'm trying to listen out for, like, new upcoming acts, but I got my core, you know, my posse.
Mm-hmm. Right. You know what I mean? Indeed. I know rap is life for you, but what if you weren't spitting bars? Like, what would Dyme-A-Duzin be doing?
I'm laying somebody down for that chicken.
Okay. All right. Dyme-A-Duzin, no rap. What's another occupation? What's something you'd be like,
I mean, I really like directing. You know, I started off with like on the YouTube channels. Like, that's how I really got my name out at first. Like, I wasn't really. Like, I was a rapper, but I was doing, like, on the side parody skits on YouTube and making my own little, like, songs that I would just remix and just make funny versions of them. Like, T-Pain, what's that thing? I Can't Believe It, I Made It, I Gotta Eat It. So it's like, you know, a song about, you know, it's not like that, but it's a funny song, like, about food. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, you know, I was just doing, like, little funny stuff.
Watch out now.
Right.
Watch out now.
Live television.
And that had to be doing well around the school too, and they were coming up to
you. Oh yeah, like, man, we used to have like these little t-shirts that we give out to everybody. Everybody was wearing them in school, giving out the CDs. Like, it was a real like big movement. Like, Morrow High School was, you know, my real big first push. And I was like 2011, I was like 16, 17. Mm-hmm. And I got a deal when I was 19. And I just turned 24. Man. So it was like, you know, it's a dope growing process, and you know, blessings.
Blessings on blessings.
Blessings on blessings.
Hey, it's been an honor, man. We appreciate you guys rocking out with
Thank
us, rocking out with B-Side.
Thank you, B-Side. Thank you, GY. Thank all you guys. You guys have been great, great vibes. Thank y'all so much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it's been a great time. And you're getting ready.
Ooh, Crown Fried coming soon. I don't want to speak on a date yet because I'm working real hard on it. Trying to get Élan.
Okay. Wow, appreciate
Élan. I need him on that.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the virtuosic verbals and swanked out sounds of Dyme-A-Duzin and crew. I know I did. He's authentic, like beef patties and bodegas on Utica Avenue. Authentic. And I, for one, can't wait to hear more from this ultra-talented artist. And if you want to hear more, B-Side, that is, you all can check out past episodes on our YouTube channel and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at #BSideBK. I'm your host, Grant Yanney. Life is a disco, so keep grooving.
Keep grooving. Oh, okay.
chat, man. Good chat.
Wanna see you dance off rhythm to a dance hall rhythm. On the floor making a booty pop. Pray the Lord of this and booty pop. Pray the dancing with a movie star. Dirty thoughts of what I do to her. White girl, she don't really listen, but this audio don't move coke like Clinton. With your dad, mind, I'm a black guy. You ever snow white off a black lie? You ever laid doves in the trap? Oh, who you know hiding dies? Rid of me that nigga. Nigga be back with the flow and the energy. My enemies lack swim more sharks when dealing with these industry cats. But what you thought was stealing me is bringing me back. It's like, you must be stuck up in a dream. It's like adding gasoline to the fire. Get me started live. I flip my verse to the world like a kilo of that white girl. She just wanna. It's a shame I'm hurting experience. Crushing up the while you crushing on these women. Cutting what I need, you be cutting when she bleed. I be in her weaving, you spend time spending. Toast to the killer dimes, linen. Ill of rhymes to solidify victims. Too sharp not to hit a mark. Who do you consider carb? Is a box to the side with him. I'm back off my field trip with that real shit for yo. So, been that beast rapping my coast. Plus, my swank is doing the most. Rock that room of life on my toes. I'm so you saying in my boast. Rock that tooth saying in my bow. My flow. So, who's saying I'm gonna blow? No. You must be stuck up in a dream. It's like adding gasoline to the fire. Get me started now. In my verse to the world like a kilo of that white girl. She just wanna party like you. Must be stuck up in a dream. It's like adding gasoline to the fire. Get me started like I flip my verse to the world like a 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Go, 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 go. Sip in the glass of liquor, another shot. Then I'm past my limit, dancing with your love. Go, 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 go. Open tap, she tripping. I got that Vans in the gas. What could you with? Would you like? Go, 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 go. Open tap, she tripping. I got the Vans in the gas. What could you with? Would you like? Go, go, go. Hey, looking right, just in them tight shirts. I think I might just, yo. White girl in the red Jeep, blonde hair in my jeans while I speed through the green lights. Whoa. Poking the nose when I'm poking the dough. So sneaks magazine like so high I can't see right. Feeling so right I can't be wrong. Can't embrace my theme song. With a daddy that I thought I only seen pawns. My Rachel Star, be my Alexis Texas. Your leggings wrap your present. Best next to my recollection. Shaking like etching sketches. You the best, the rest was sketchy. Be like I'm the president. President of Rolex. Presidents of my wallet. Hold these pockets on precious. You know about pretending these souls are soling you. Shining hard and I'm high exposing you. White all over like Christmas. White all over like Christmas. White all over like Christmas. I explode on you. White all over like I explode on you. White all over like. Woo!
Thank y'all so much, Brooklyn!